Alright, my opponent kept 7. This is 6. This hand would be great against a lot of decks. Turn 2, Thirst. Turn 3, either cast Thirst or Tezzeret. But against an Affinity deck, I actually don't know if this is good enough. It doesn't have any removal spells. Yeah, you know, I think I can actually do better. Alright. I think I like this, just because not having a removal spell to play on turn 2 or 3, or even necessarily 4, just seems like too much. I get that you can Thirst on turn 3, so turn 4 I probably have a decent play, but having nothing to do the turns leading up to that seems like a deal breaker. For example, if my opponent were to play Cranial Plating and attack me on this next turn. Well, I drew a Talisman, which means if I don't need to keep up Smother, I can have a turn 3 Tezzeret, but I also have the option of keeping up Smother. I don't know if I like having Aether Vial and Springleaf Drum in the same deck. Seems like a lot of mana sources. Maybe it's instead of Moxes. I guess makes you more consistent but less explosive. Alright, my opponent's got lots of mana out here. Steel Overseer. I guess that I'm going to have to kill. I think that's worth getting rid of here. And opponent's on one card. Could be plating easily, since you would play Overseer there instead of plating. But I don't know if there's anything I can do about that right now. I mean, I can play a Talisman next turn and then follow up with a Tezzeret, making Talisman into a 5/5, but that's about it. Oh, nothing. So got a couple options here. I can play Talisman, but I think I'd rather just play Liliana and actually just kill the Ornithopter. This uses my mana better because I play a 3 into a 4. My opponent's cards in hand could be like Galvanic Blast, so if I plus 1 this, then get it Galvanic Blasted, that's not great. And this means that if my opponent peels a Cranial Plating, nominally the best card in their deck, they at least have to wait a turn before doing anything. Though I guess Aether Vial actually does mean something's coming out here. But yeah, I still like using Liliana this way. Getting Galvanic Blasted, I'm actually happy with that. Or getting Shrapnel Blasted? Oh, Boros Charm. Well, that's a counter to Damnation. It's hard to cast, but with Drum, Glimmer Void, and Mox, I guess you can cast it. Alright. I guess this turn played out pretty well for me, since I'm gonna still kill the Ornithopter and trade Liliana for a Boros Charm, which I'm happy with. And then next turn I can just play Tezzeret and plus it if my opponent has a 2-2 Steel Overseer. Basically, if my opponent draws a creature next turn, that's pretty good for them, but if they do not, I'm in pretty good shape. It is good, I guess, that Aether Vial does get to play around Damnation pretty well here. I wonder if my opponent thought I was plussing Liliana, because if I'm minusing Liliana, the whole line of like Violin Overseer and then Boros Charm Liliana doesn't make a ton of sense. So I do not expect Steel Overseer to attack regardless here. It just does not make that much sense, unless there's like a Cranial Plating drawn or something. Oh, Thoughtseize, that was good for me. I would choose to put Thoughtseize on top of my opponent's deck there. I have double Tezzeret. I do not need the second one very much here. My plan right now, unless I draw something that changes it, is to play Tezzeret plus it, goes up to 4. My opponent can make Overseer a 2-2 and attack Tezzeret for 2, that's fine. I'm still getting to plus Tezzeret and drawing into reasonable value. Talisman going down, yeah, that's fine too. I mean, I can't animate it, but because, you know, now, but I get to keep plussing Tezzerets. Oh, there's a Dimir Signet. It is a Mirror Signet. I'm still just going to cast Tezzeret and plus it here. Let's see what we hit. Can I get an artifact of some kind? No. I mean, I did side out a couple artifacts. I do have to keep that in mind. That's fine. I think my opponent's still in not great shape. I mean, if they draw a decent creature here, then that's something. But otherwise, I get to next turn play Dimir Signet and then make it into a 5/5. And I've got Mutavault and Creeping Tar Pit. So even if I'm drawing lands, I still have good things to do. And if I'm drawing spells, I can like kill Steel Overseer or deal with whatever it is my opponent's playing here. I think this hand did a lot better than the one I would have kept otherwise, because if I didn't kill that the first Steel Overseer, then I would have been in big trouble. And if File on 2 and 3 means if you draw an Ornithopter, you have to play it right away, or like a Signal Pest if that's in the deck, or Memnite. I mean, I don't know exactly what's in my opponent's list here. If my opponent passes without playing anything, then it's a little harder for me to figure out, because Vial's on 2 and 3. 3 indicates Master of Ethereum, potentially, and we know about Etch Champion. 2 indicates Steel Overseer, Vault Scourge, and Arcbound Ravager, plus Bellskite, potentially. So, a lot of different things that could come out, especially if my opponent just waits and does not do anything. I like Liliana. I think I play Signet. Yeah, let's play Signet, and then Liliana and minus it on my opponent. And this either kills the Steel Overseer or forces my opponent to put something into play first. And depending on what it is, then I'll decide what I want to do with Tezzeret here. See if my opponent found a creature to violin. Nope, they did not. So I'm guessing that that's the case. I mean, obviously my opponent could just game me by violating a creature, but why would you miss the Steel Overseer pump? Because of that, I'd rather just plus Tezzeret now. No reason to minus it. I mean, I could. If I thought the Tezzeret might die to attacks, I'd rather just make Signet a 5-5 while I've got a chance. Given that it does not seem like it's under current danger, I might as well do this. Let's see. It hit a Darksteel Citadel, putting a bunch of cards on the bottom. And I get to play Darksteel Citadel, in fact, which I will. Having the second Tezzeret in hand does mean it's kind of hard to empty my hand for Liliana, but I don't know if that matters too much. My opponent's in tough shape here. I've got double Planeswalker, and Tezzeret's going to make a pair of 5-5s that are just going to go off here in a second. Probably just not plussing Liliana here. I mean, if my opponent's got nothing, then it doesn't do anything, and if my opponent has a creature in hand, then they can vial it out in response, and I just discard a Tezzeret for no reason. So, time to activate my Darksteel Citadel. Well, Tezzeret it, rather. Time to activate my Creeping Tar Pit. And let's tap like this. I'm just going to leave one Mutavault back, I guess. Since my opponent's super dead next turn from this, no reason to, I don't know, let my opponent vial in a Master Ethereum or a Ravager and get me here. I'm just going to pass. Like I said, I don't think there's a big reason. Like, I could plus Liliana before attacking to get full information out of my opponent, but it wouldn't have changed my plays very much, so I don't think there's a reason to do that. Opponent's pretty flooded here and is pretty dead next turn to Tezzeret here. So now since I really don't think I'm going to need this second Tez, I could just do that. All right. It's Inquisition my opponent. Pretty unexpected, I think. And then send in with two artifacts for 10. Ooh, my opponent did draw a creature. And etch it as champion. All right. I have two artifacts, so I can't. I mean, Tezzeret's ultimate is clearly not going to do anything. Let's activate those two and activate a Mutavault. And my opponent has to chump one of the artifacts here and take 7, going to 3, dead to Creeping Tar Pit, dead to basically everything. Yeah, Tezzeret. It looks like my opponent's draw this game was not horrendous. It was kind of the risk affinity always takes when you board in Boros Charm and Thoughtseize, and you end up, you know, draw with a Boros Charm, a Thoughtseize, and 2 Steel Overseers as the threats, plus a bunch of land. So it wasn't a good draw overall, but if you exchange one of those threats or one of the answer cards, the sideboard cards, for a Master, an Arcbound Ravager, or whatever, then I would have been in a lot more trouble.